And you see, wasting away a salat, there is a natural consequence that comes after that. And that is that when a person is not insulated with the insulation of prayer, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala allows all sorts of sicknesses of the heart and all sorts of bad deeds to occur at the hands of this individual. You see, if you are sitting in one place and you are praying salah, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala places between you and evil a special type of barrier that is almost feelable if you're actually regularly praying salah. When you hear of something evil, immediately your heart finds, you know, resistance to this evil. However, when a person ends up leaving off the salah, that resistance is decreased. And Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala tells us of this phenomenon in the Quran as well. Inna salata tanha anil fahsha'i wal munkar. Indeed, prayer ends up stopping a person from al-fahsha'. It stops a person from filthy, obscene things, and it also stops a person from al-munkar, all other types of evil as well. So when you pray salah, you place between you and other evil a guard. You literally do what they call a taqwa, because taqwa comes from the word wiqaya, which is a protection, right? So you place between yourself and other evils a type of protection. You place between yourself and all types of obscene and nasty and so on and so forth and filthy things. You place between yourself and those things a barrier. And the Messenger sallallahu alaihi wasallam, he said, لَيْسَ الْمُؤْمِنُ بِاللَّعَانِ وَلَا الطَّعَانِ وَلَا الْفَاحِشُ وَلَا الْبَذِي. That a believer is not a person who ends up cursing other people by doing la'na upon them, by sending la'na upon them, i.e. cursing them, right? He doesn't have that type of tongue. And the Prophet ﷺ said, وَلَا الْفَاحِشُ. And the person is neither, a believer is not a person who happens to be obscene as well in his speech and his character as well. So why did he gain this ability to stay away from al-la'na? لَيْسَ الْمُؤْمِنُ بِاللَّعَانِ وَلَا الطَّعَانِ. Neither is he poking fun at people, and nor is he fahish. How did he gain that character? He gained that through praying salah and through establishing the obligations of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. However, when you don't establish this obligation of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, Allah says the natural consequences is what? Is وَاتَّبَعُ الشَّهَوَاتِ. And then they end up falling prey to their own desires, right? Because the barrier is gone. We were saying that salah is a barrier. It places a barrier between yourself and evil. Now that you're not praying salah anymore, that barrier has been released. It's been taken away from you. And no longer can you have that same sort of protection against your own self, against your desires. Recognize that at times your own desires are stronger than even shaitan. So the point is that your shahwa sometimes is even stronger than shaitan. So recognize that. The one way for you to protect yourself against your shahwa is what? Is your salah. And obviously, if you are able to protect yourself against your own shahwa, desire, through salah, then naturally you can protect yourself against shaitan, even more so with salah as well, because shaitan is weaker than your shahwa.